Hi, welcome to the Boerma Institute. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. Welcome, my name is Jacqueline Boerma. I'm going to make the live stream today. And we are going to create some chaos. Last week and the last 2 weeks, we had the master course, the International Master Florist Education with Gregor Lerch. And it was, Wednesday was the last day. And then we have cleaned up. And I thought there were some very beautiful arrangements and some very beautiful flowers left over, some beautiful flowers left over, and I'm going to use those. One of the students of the International Master Florist Education, she created a frame with using the rattan. And I took it apart and I'm going to reuse it. So I have created this on a wire, and I put it on a strong double wire. It's 1.4, and I'm going to put it in my container. And in the container, I'm using the Oasis biodegradable foam. And I'm going to create a little bit of a mess. Well, actually, it is already a mess, but I'm going to put some ends into the Oasis. So I'm also creating some down striving things going into the Oasis, going around my arrangement, around my container. So my container also plays a role, and my frame is a little bit more secure into the Oasis, so it doesn't fall apart. So although it looks a mess, it's a kind of tidy mess, I hope. Oh, that is very nice. I have some less light into my face, so I can see a little bit more clearer. So I'm using this orange and pink rattan. The rattan is also still for sale in our webshop, as you probably know. And if not, then you know now. So visit our webshop sometimes for some nice materials, some wires, some books. Also, we still have some books for sale from Gregor Lerch and other designers. Unfortunately, we don't have a book ourselves, but maybe it will come. So now it's more secure. Let's see, let's do this one also. Yep, inside the Oasis, like that. I have some beautiful flowers, as I said, left over. These are already 2 weeks old. When they came in from Deco Fresh Roses. And they're beautiful. This one doesn't have a name yet, but I think I know a very good name for this. It's pink, it's lovely, and I think it's going to be, I hope so, maybe it's called Jacqueline, maybe, who knows. So I'm going to use this inside my frame, and I should water it later on because the Oasis is not completely until the bottom of the container. But it's a little bit higher than the bottom, so I will use some water inside so they can still last for at least 3 weeks, I think. Actually, Tricia made this frame on a wooden wooden log, and then I took it apart and reframed it. And then in between the space, I will put my flowers in. So I create some depths with it. And I have some Lycospermum nutans from Iobi flowers, South Africa. They came in as well. And we had some beautiful new colors, also without names. Oh, yeah. and they last very long as well, creating some depths when I put them inside my container, inside my frame. Is that my first question, Angelica, or are you just reusing your...
I was preparing my attention stick, but there are some comments. We have Herman Swanepoel saying, good day all from South Africa.
Oh, nice. Good day to you.
And we have Taiwan saying, hi, Ian just returned back to Taiwan. Thanks for the wonderful course and host of Taiwanese teachers.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure to have them here. They all did a great job. This was only the first 10 days of the course. And in March, we will have the second 10 days. And it's always a pleasure to have Gregor in the house with his beautiful designs and inspirational lessons. So we are very happy to host it. Mike is saying something, but I didn't get that completely. Yes, the teachers from Taiwan were doing a great job. I think everybody was doing a great job. How many countries did we have? Like 9 different countries? We had Yulin, we had Ian, Jasper Wu, and Ethan Wang. So we had 4 people from Taiwan. We had some people from South Africa, from Canada, from the US. We had also 3 students from, let me check. I was checking my Gerbera. Yeah, so 3 students from Holland as well. And from Estonia, we had 2 teachers. We had also from Hungary. So we had a very international group altogether. I said that America, yes. So the chaos is getting there. Some lovely pasta gerberas with some nice green tips. So the green of the begonia and the green that is in the gerbera as well, they come together. I'm not making a hole this time before I put my gerbera in, but just pushing it in one go. Yes, Angelica.
Yes, we have Nidhi Pandey saying hi. Thank you for this live stream.
You're welcome. Thank you for joining. I'm using some Dekker chrysanthemums at the base, some spider chrysanthemums. They are also already 2 weeks old, so I will use them short in the base on top of my oasis, so to get the lighter color at the base. And I have to turn and make some, oops, noise. And I have also some rescued carnations, a little bit blurry colors. And I wonder if you know how the South African florist call this color. I'm using them at the base, so I cover my brown foam. The foam is 91% biodegradable. Oops, making a bigger chaos. Anybody already know how the South African florist called this color? Angelica, you know. Yes, how coral, coral set. How do they call the color?
Beetroot puke.
Beetroot puke, yes, that's the color. But it's a not so nice name for the color, but it's a beautiful carnation. I'm using them deep, so. And they smell nice as well. They smell just like the white carnation, the original carnation, and it really has a typical carnations fragrance. Yes.
We have Bertrand Dunienville saying hello from Mauritius. Glad to see you again.
Nice to see you again. Welcome back.
And Henny Dekker says, nu al prachtig met deze kleuren.
Dankjewel,
so already
Henny.
Very beautiful with all these colors.
Thank you, Henny. Thank you for joining as well again. So I'm keeping most of my materials inside the container, inside the frame. Otherwise, it will be a little bit too high. And too much for my short container. Sometimes I group the materials, like the Gerberas, I group them now a little bit. And on some other places, I keep them apart. So it's a little bit more playful. I have some beautiful Nerines. Those are from Marginpar, eh, Mike? Yeah. Those curvy, curly Nerines. So, April 1st, we will have an open house with the exam work of the International Master Florist Education. So, if you are in Holland and around, then please visit us, because we will have some lovely work to show you. I'm using some pink anthuriums. These are not sold as cut flowers. I didn't buy them as cut flowers, but we bought them as plants. So they're cut right off the plant. I'm using it in water first. I kept them in water first, and now I'm using them in the oasis. And my father would say, those colors, the orange and the pink, cannot go together. Like orange and yellow, they cannot go together. But nowadays, they're fine. I think we have changed using colors. And it's nice to make a difference every time. So, yes, Angelica.
Yes, first we have Duya Marsa giving you an applause.
Oh, hello, Duya.
And Taiwan is giving you a thumbs up.
Oh, thank you, Taiwan.
And we have Jade in the chat saying, hello to everyone from UK. Jacqueline, that looks amazing already. Go big or go home.
Thank you, Jade. Thank you for helping us out also with the master course. We were happy that you were back to help us prepare the materials for the lessons with Gregor.
Yes, very much appreciated.
Although Gregor does a lot of preparing at home, he brought a whole truck full of frames and beautiful prepared materials. We always have a lot to do during the course. So we ask students of our professional course and advanced course to help out. And they always enjoy working together closely with Gregor. for preparing. And I keep turning my arrangements, so oops, and I also keep throwing my lanterns on the side. This was wired, huh? Yes, this was wired. So this is a lotus fruit, which was reused. So we put it on a thick wire, like a 0.6 wire. And they're not very common here in Holland. We don't get them often, so I'm happy to use them. They're wired from the inside, so you don't see the actual wire. And I'm standing beside a frame that you can see the wax plate. That's made by Gregor for the master course. He did a beautiful design with that. I think Mike will show you a picture right later when we do the editing. There will be, this one is too high. There will be a picture inside the edit version. So you can see the whole thing. Yes.
We have Bonita Gaetan saying, hello from, I'm from USA, extraordinary design. And Herman Swanepoel says, Jacqueline, thank you for your inspirational designs. I am learning a lot and helps me with wedding arrangement and venue arrangement.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you for the compliments. I'm happy that you enjoy it. Oh. That was not cut at an angle. So I'm also using some roses deeper on the base. So the beautiful wrinkled effect. No, the, wait, it, see that rose? What's that effect? That one. See? Ruffled. Ruffled effect. I like that a lot. So it's also shown deeper inside the oasis now, inside the container. So it's more interesting to look inside it as well. These came as cut flowers, these anthuriums. Also, I took them out of some arrangement that we had to take apart. So I will use them again. When I was like about 4 years old, I was a bridesmaid. And together with another bridesmaid, we were walking in front of the couple that was going to be married. And she was throwing her flowers on the floor and her roses on the floor because we had such a cute little flower baskets with roses and petals. And I was always lifting them up again and putting them in my bucket because I thought it was a pity to throw away. So that's what I do here. I reuse the flowers. Yeah.
So Jade says, oh, thank you guys. It was my absolute pleasure. Hope to see you soon again. Kisses.
Hope to see you soon. Not hiding behind my arrangement, am I? Again, not too much. So inside the container is also getting pretty much filled. And I like the Bergenia leaves together with this anthurium, the green and pink anthurium. Because it brings the colors together. So that's what I like about that. Making sure that I don't hide the structure on the inside of my container. I also want to see the rattan branches inside my arrangement. And I had some more leaves. So I have some pretty good news. Last week, Gregor and Mike and I decided that we will hold the International Master Florist Education one more time. So in 2023, in November, we will start again with a new group. And then we will do it again. What are you doing, guys? It was falling apart. Oh, the mic is not holding it. Okay. So I'm using a little bit of the Hypericum inside. I don't have a lot. I just have one. But it's nice to do that. One, two, there you go. Some nice anthurium underneath my Lycospermum nutans. Some orange, should I? Maybe it will be too much orange now. Let's see. But I like the fiery part about it. Let's make some summer in the autumn. Angelica.
Aurora Bright says, hello, I'm from India myself, Anchal, and I also want to become a professional designer. I am pursuing my graduation in agriculture, so what should I do next?
If you like to become a florist, then you can join our, and you have not done anything yet in floristry, or already doing it for a couple of years, then you can join our professional course. Our professional course is 2 times a year, 1 time in January and 1 time in September. And then it's 5 weeks, 5 days per week, so 25 days. And then we have lessons from 10 to 3:45. And that at the end you have an exam. So we do all the things that a Dutch florist needs to know and needs to do. So we do bridal work, funeral work, hand-tied bouquets, table arrangements. And that's a very interesting course. We do a lot of different techniques. We do a lot of different styles. So you can join that, and then after you've joined that, then you can do, for example, the advanced course, or you can do an event course. After the advanced course, we also have the, as I said before, the International Master Florist Education, and we also have master classes with very interesting people like Brigitte Heinrichs, with Frederic Dupré, Nico Bocantia. So, there are a lot of possibilities to become a florist. If you only want to sell bouquets, we also have 2 days hand-tied bouquet courses. Yeah.
Ethan Wang says hi.
Hi, Ethan. I'm glad you're back safe. Nice to see you from here. I hope you have enjoyed during the master education.
So whose design was it that you were using?
I'm reusing the frame from Tricia Won. Tricia is from United States, and I took hers apart and reused the rattan because she put a block of wood underneath. She made it with the chicken foot and the frame with iron. I took that all apart. I cut it out and I reused the messy part, the chaos. So, I should sharpen my knife a bit.
And who are these lycospermums from again?
Oh, these lycospermums are from Ioba flowers. And some of them don't have names yet, eh? You should see one, this one. That's my favorite color. Can you please show that? This is a very special one because it's a little bit pinkish. And before they were yellow, orange and red, but now this one is very nice and light. This is very beautiful in bridal work as well. So also this one doesn't have a name yet. So maybe, who knows? Maybe you can do some suggestions for names for this beautiful pink rose. And for this beautiful pink Lycospermum nutans. I love the word Lycospermum nutans. Lycospermum means white seed. So that's why I can remember it. Lycospermum. I think I've covered my inside more or less. Let me check. Yep. Now I probably can see a little bit better. Yeah, I also love the begonia leaves. The color of it is very nice together with my other materials. I think I shouldn't do much more on it about it. Let's see. No, let the water run out. Or maybe one more thing, because one of the students, she came in and she helped. With some designs. Maybe I'll hang this one inside it later. Let me check that after the live stream. And then, oops, yes, that's why. And then you can see that on the photo when it's edited. Yeah. So now we're going to do a little bit of rearranging. Because I'm going to make a bigger arrangement. Ja. Zal ik het tillen?
Ja, is goed.
Nee, wait.
Mm-hmm. Of zal ik hem gewoon even afhalen?
Let's see. Was it like that? No. Yeah, and then you can take it off. Mm-hmm. Yep. There's water inside, hè?
Yep. Very careful.
Yep.
Nice sound.
Nee, this one is in front.
Yep.
This part. So, you probably have seen this frame before. This is one of my favorite frames that I like to use. It's a nice pedestal with a metal container on it. And I've used some magnolia branches inside. Again, there is Oasis biodegradable foam. And there's a branch that comes from Nelly. So Nelly, thank you very much again. And also the branches are from Nelly, by the way. Then I've used some Monstera leaves, some Begonia leaves. Then this hanging part here, and Rypsalis, yes. And then, sorry, I forgot to mention that. And then I have taped it with some waterproof tape, some anchor tape from Oasis. And I've used some branches from the garden from Chris. And then I will need some flowers. Ja, dat is ook goed. Maar ik heb toch wel wat bloemen nodig, schat. Oh, yes. We'll get back to you for the name. I have some heliconia. Ik heb die hele kar nodig, hoor, Mike, die daar staat. And I will place them to the height. A little bit together. And I have some beautiful anthuriums. Should I place this a little bit more to the back so we have more space in front? Because I don't need to walk around it. So welcome back to the live stream. My name is Jacqueline Boerma. This is the second piece that we do today. Bless you. Some nice anthuriums, big ones. And I'm going to use them a little bit horizontal. So I use them as a saucer, like that. Not too much going like this. Then it will be too big for me. But a little bit like that. So they fit together with the Monstera leaves. And then I will place one on the opposite side. Is that too far? No, that's fine. Like that, so to give some color to the front as well. And then I have some asparagus leaves somewhere. Yep, thank you. And I will use that hanging to the front. And I love the decorative part of the wood in it. And I want to show that. Because if you hide it, I think it's a pity that you have it inside there. So, oops, maybe that can go there. Yep. And then again, I have some beautiful red ones, Lycospermum. And I'll just make a bunch of them here, just because I can. And I always feel uncomfortable throwing things on the floor, so I'll get my container for my garbage a little bit more closer by. And I make a group of the Lycospermums here, and also on the other side, somewhere there, because that one comes nicely to the front. Are there any questions for me, maybe? Oh, don't get stuck. Angelica,
no.
Catch. Thank you. Otherwise, I get stuck. Yeah, so this one is nicely horizontal. So this one comes on the opposite side. That's Jake. We probably have some visitors. If you hear a dog bark, then it's Jake. He's our branch assistant, manager assistant, something like that. Assistant branch manager. And maybe Axel will show him after the live stream when we say goodbye. And I'm reusing some of the roses. These are also the DecoFresh roses. Let me see. Go to the back a little bit so I get some depth with my roses. Can't see it very clearly from this distance. I like to use them in a group. Yes, Angelica.
Nidhi Pandey says it's a beautiful flower arrangement.
Thank you, thank you. I always enjoy making these bigger arrangements. So I hope Mike and I can do a nice one on stage of the AIFD convention in Chicago, eh, Mike? We will be there at the beginning. I think it's the 4th of July even. That we have the demonstration there on stage. Yes, the AIFD symposium in Chicago. Did I say convention? AIFD convention? AIFD symposium. Look how nice and big they are. Yes, I just said that they are from DecoFresh roses. And they have a little bit pink inside, some of them. So that's a nice color as well. But you know, I'm not a very big pink fan.
Liar, liar.
Some beautiful lycodendrons. Quite tough to cut. Like that. Then I still need something. Let me see. Can these go here or should they go to the opposite side there? Probably because I think they need to go here because on the opposite side I already have the branches of the magnolia. So I don't want to make a fuss here in between because these are so beautiful. I like to show the shape of the branches here. Let's add some more. That's a nice steady group, so you can see them clearly. And then I could use some, let me step out of the plates. Here you go. Oops, don't mess that up. probably you don't see it from here, but if you walk around it, oh, I can turn it. If you walk around it, then you can see it also has some materials to the back, so it's really three-dimensional. And I will use some skimmia to fill. Yes.
Su Sung says, long time no see, guys. Glad to see the diva herself back in action. Greetings to everyone at Burma.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Lovely that you join again. Some skimmia in there. Some wintry material here in Holland. And to fill that up, that space behind my nice branch. Not too high though, because otherwise I cover up the roses. The diva herself. You're funny. So we will also have some Christmas courses soon coming up. We will do a wall decoration and a table decoration and a horizontal table decoration. And we will also do our oval Christmas tree with oasis blocks. So we build a oasis tree. A Christmas tree ourselves with some nice decorative materials. I also have some beautiful Vanda roots. And they can go from here. I wired them. I put them on double legs, actually two double legs of 1.0. So I can put my Vanda roots in, not exactly inside the oasis, but a wire goes inside the oasis. Kan iemand alsjeblieft die kar wat dichterbij zetten, zodat ik niet iedere keer uit beeld hoef te lopen. Then I have some branches, I don't know what they are, but they are from the nursery Morning Glory, and we are happy to have them. And they will go at the back to add some depth. Yeah, thank you. In a group as well, and then maybe let's see how this looks. If I have two there, then I can have probably this one here at the base. So from there to there, and this one from here to here, the anthurium, and then I have some Vanda roots. And what I also still have is some beautiful amaranthus. Yeah, thank you. Some beautiful amaranthus. It's green and red. In our garden we have some huge amaranthus, also beautiful. I will try to collect some seeds from this and then we put them in the garden. So we'll have some of our own next year. Then I put that there. So it's also more like a floating line going down. Is that too close or too far away? Yeah, that's fine. Maybe I add one more. Then I have a little bit less space in between. No, can't do that. No, it's not going to work. Then I place that one here. So you see the color from right front to left back a bit. Then I also have some lycodendron. And I'll place that, if I can reach it. Yep, there. Behind the lycosperms. Lycodendron, lycospermum, all these nice words. Yes, Angelica.
Yes, we have Jenny NG from Canada in the chat.
Nice, from Canada. Thank you very much for joining. Does she have a question?
No.
No? Just saying that she's watching us. That's nice. Some more oases to cover. Then I have a beautiful short hydrangea. Also the color, yeah, it's a little bit older, poor guy. Also the red and the green. So it combines the two colors together. And I think that one wants to go there on top. Otherwise those two heliconias are a little bit empty. Maybe I could use a third one. I will try to not kill it, but it needs a third heliconia there. I think, yeah, it needs it there. Yes, Angelica.
Yeah, Susang says, how are you guys dealing with the high flower prices these days?
Yeah, I think in Holland they're not very high at the moment. I think they're actually a nice price at the wholesaler. Yeah, it's not that bad. It's a little bit higher, but it's all right. But it's not winter time yet, eh? So it's still kind of warmish here for autumn. But later on, probably we'll have some difficulties with the prices. So we will use. We will start more ikebana, maybe a little bit less flowers. Does that need it to go there? Where does it need to go? Maybe here. Not too far out in between my branches, but it still needs some depth there. And then I'll have another one of the hydrangea. And then it will go there. Thank you. Then I go a little bit more orangey, I guess. Do I? I'm just thinking where to place it. Can you see my? I think I need something here because this is red. This is a little bit red, but this is very green and dark here, so it needs something. But these tips, they have cut them off. So can you find another one that looks a little bit nicer? Oh yeah. They're all cut, but yeah, this one hangs more down than these guys.
I have a Thank very you. Big one in the back, if you like, that has a point. It's dried.
Oh, no, I think this, if I hang this down, see, then it will droop down a little bit, so you don't see the cut. So I guess that one can go. Wait, need to get some strings in there. Yeah. Next to the roots of the Vanda. Well, the roots of the Vanda, they come from Anzu Vanda. So because Gregor was here in the school, he wanted to cut some Vanda roots for us, because normally he does not do that. Because of course he likes to sell the Vandas, which is normal for a Vanda grower. But we were lucky that we had some Vanda roots as well. Angelica.
Bonita Gaitan says, as an amateur, I get very excited when I'm thinking a design could use this or that, and the master designer eventually sees it as well, just like that.
Thank you for your comment. That's nice to share. Yes, I think it needs a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Some you can imagine it in your head, but when the materials, it's natural material, so every stem is different. So it's always good to have a little bit extra on hand, so you don't run out of materials. And it can also use a little bit more, a little bit more lycodendron inside here. So next to that anthurium, you have a little bit more color inside the frame. I don't want to use it too long outside, but a little bit inside, so you can still see. You can still see this nice frame of the wood. And then I think because when I did the international master florist with Gregor, and we passed, Mike and I passed, I think what Gregor would think about this arrangement is that it has a flat nose. So it has a little bit of flat nose. So I will use this branch for the rose hips a little bit above it. So it's not that flat. It's a little bit more, it's still there, but it's a little bit not so huge nose. Okay.
Is it creating dimension?
Yeah, it's creating depth. Yeah. And then I still need to have a little bit of something here. I think I can use a little bit of the Bergenia leaves, because I still see the edge of my container. And I still see some wire of my Vanda roots. And you see that I'm using my my groups a little bit different, so they're not the same size. So my lycospermums on one side, they have more flowers than the group of lycospermums on the right side here. So they're also asymmetrical. Oh, that's a bit too much, or is it too high? This rose hip is in the way of my Bergenia leaf. Or my Bergenia leaf in the way. Oops, yes. Oh, there it is. Yep. And then I still see a hole. So I need a red. Oops. I need one more red. There it is. I need one more red lycospermum on that side, because I still see some oasis here. Also, to give it to go shorter. So again, it gives some depth. Yeah. And then I think it's busy enough. I think I have done enough materials on it. In it. If you have any questions for me, any remarks, any questions, please say so.
I have a remark.
Okay.
I like it.
Oh, thank you. That's always good. We will place it in the bar,
yeah,
so you can still have a look at it. So I'd like to thank you all guys for watching the live stream. Please like and subscribe. Push the bell button so you can keep updated with us when we do it again. Within 14 days, we do it again. I don't know exactly who does it, but I think it's going to be Mike. Not sure though. So I hope to see you in the next live stream or here at the school. And thank you very much for watching. Yes, thumbs up. Yes, thumbs up.
Yes.
Please like and subscribe.
Exactly. So thank you very much, everyone, for watching. Hope you had a great time. If you would like to support our live streams, you can do so by supporting us on our Patreon, which is patreon.com/flowerschool. And over there, for a small fee a month, you can really help us out creating these videos, as you know, there's a lot of materials going in there, and that helps us buy the flowers, create these structures and stuff beforehand. And in return, we keep on creating these videos. That makes it easier for us. But also, you can see some behind the scenes footage. So sometimes every month we upload maybe one video in which you can see how we created some of the structures, or we give you something extra that has nothing to do with the live streams. That is also possible, like an interview or something. We sometimes post interesting interviews or other things that we have created over the time. You will see the videos that we have edited without ads in them. So all sorts of stuff. So patreon.com/flowerschool. And then thank you very much again, everyone, and hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you next time. Come, Jack. Jack, come. Come. Come.
Come
here. Bye-bye.